Today we're visiting a sanctuary for many, the City of Saints, Assisi. Andiamo! Assisi is an Umbrian jewel in the province of Perugia that lies delicately on the slopes of Mount Subasio. The Piazza del Comune has always been the hub of social and cultural life of Assisi. It's no coincidence that all the main roads coming from the city gates converge at this point. The square is surrounded by medieval buildings, and in the center has a beautiful fountain. With good reason, it's considered one of the most representative urban realizations of medieval Umbria, as there is documented information of its presence since the beginning of the 13th century. The so-called Temple of Minerva, of Augustan art built in 30 BC, was transformed later into the Church of Santa Maria sopra Minerva in the 16th century. The name derives from a later interpretation due to the discovery of a female statue. The facade is surprisingly well preserved. Still in its original state, the six columns are surmounted by a fine capital in pure Corinthian style and rest on plinths which, due to lack of space, are placed on the staircase enclosed by porticos. In 1539, Pope Paul III wanted to transform its interior into a Catholic church dedicated to the Virgin. The building was then remodeled in the Baroque style in the 17th century. Also known as Italy's Green Heart, this landlocked region benefits from local produce harvested and meat grazed on its gently sloping hills. It's also an area well known for hunting of wild boar, pigeon, and truffles. Perhaps the most well-known attraction in Assisi is the Basilica of San Francesco. It's the place that since the year 1230 has preserved and guarded the mortal remains of the saint. 2 years after his death, Saint Francis was considered one of the most significant figures in the history of Christianity. For this reason, as the founder of the order, an adequate size was prepared for a pilgrimage and popular devotion destination. He and Saint Catherine of Siena are the patron saints of Italy, and he himself is also the patron saint of ecology and of animals. Later in his life, Francis reportedly received a vision that left him with the stigmata of Christ, marks resembling the wounds that Jesus Christ had suffered when he was crucified, making Francis the first person to receive such holy wounds. In lieu of this and his works, he was canonized as a saint on the 16th of July, 1228. The cathedral is the main place of Catholic worship in the city of Assisi and is consecrated to San Rufino, a martyr bishop of the 3rd century. Here, practically since shortly after his death, his body is still preserved. The church, built starting in 1029, was awarded the title of cathedral in 1036. The mini shops display a variety of local arts and crafts, including paintings, sculptures, ceramics, and reproductions of medieval weapons and tools. Embroidery and chocolate manufacturing are also typical of the area and found in most stores. Like a lot of Italy's historical centers, there are winding alleys, steep inclines, and at times challenging footing, depending where you explore in the town. Definitely do bring a comfortable pair of shoes if you plan to explore as much as possible. I wanted to note if you are arriving by train, the station itself is not in the historical center. The station services both Assisi and adjacent town Santa Maria degli Angeli. If you are staying in the Centro Storico, you can take a bus from the station or arrange a taxi service. Both options are available as you exit the station. Once you reach the 19th century square of Santa Chiara, from which you can enjoy a stunning view over the Umbrian Valley, the religious building with white and pink stone bands stands out with the adjoining convent dedicated to Chiara, the first and most faithful disciple of St. Francis. Chiara was an Italian nun, collaborator of St. Francis of Assisi, and founder of the Order of the Poor Clares. She was canonized as St. Clare in 1255 by Pope Alexander IV due to her renowned holiness and sanctity of life. This stunning collection of lavender is located in Castelnuovo in the province of Assisi, about 20 minutes outside of the historical center. The annual Lavender Festival typically runs towards the end of June into early July. Home to 3 hectares of botanical gardens, where flowering fields of white, pink, blue, and purple lavender await. The gardens have over 70 varieties of flowering sages and a variety of other aromatic plants. In the lavender field, visitors can learn how to use lavender in the kitchen, take a painting class, go horseback riding, and even compete in a bouquet-making contest. There are two official lavender shops in the center of Assisi where you can buy a variety of products and also let yourself be intoxicated by a flood of perfume. Over the centuries, farmers have developed clever ways of taking what was available from their land, meat offcuts and seasonal local produce, and working magic, cucina povera, or peasant cookery. The Umbria region has lots of delicious foods it's famous for, and many an option to tempt you to taste, like the torta al testo, ragù d'agnello, Rocciata, Strengozzi, and Tartufo Nero. Well, I really hope you all enjoyed this visit through the stunning and magical town of Assisi. Until next time, alla prossima! Did you enjoy this episode? Please hit the like button and subscribe to be in the know for future episodes.